You've come a long way. You must be tired. And if my envoys are correct, you haven't had a lot of rest recently. Please, Sheriff, relax for a moment, will you? Do you want a drink? Something to eat? Vivian makes a very nice, very... It's elegant. Really, a carpaccio. It's lobster. Sirloin.
Got a scotch?
Only Tennessee whiskey, unfortunately. What do you think you're doing?
He's gonna...
Mr. Wolf is our guest, and I have every intention of cooperating. So don't waste the silver. Sit down, Jersey. Well, Sheriff, for the sake of transparency, why don't you tell us why you're here? It would help settle everyone's nerves, I think.
You know why I'm here. You killed those women.
What women?
Faith and Lily, the girls who worked at the Pudding and Pie.
Did I now? I assume by your confidence in accusing me, you must have some proof of this, yes? Some allotment of evidence. A witness, perhaps.
I don't need evidence. I don't carry a badge, there's no appeals, and you're guilty until I say otherwise. That's how this works.
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I wish you had me dead to rights. I really do, for your own sake. But no, I didn't kill anyone. Those women. I don't relish telling you that the killings were perpetrated by an employee of mine. It's a very unfortunate bit of business, but I promise you that the matter will be dealt with internally. I just want to settle the issue for you and to assure you that it's over with. You really don't need to worry yourself further.
An unfortunate bit of business? You're gonna tell me right now who killed him.
Sheriff, I have complete respect for you and your job. I hope you know that. But I simply can't divulge that information. You really shouldn't worry yourself. As I said, I've got this under control.
No, I'm gonna deal with it right now.
Yeah, right. What do you think this is? Some kind of negotiation? The man said he'd take care of it. So why don't you take the hint and get out?
I'm the law here, not you. Now tell me who did it.
You think I'm scared of you? You're nothing more
That's
than a-
That's enough! I was hoping it wouldn't come to this, but in the interest of preserving our alliance, if you have to know, it was Georgie. However, like I said, I'd be handling the matter if you don't mind.
Georgie.
You got what you wanted, so just...
Sit down. Now.
Yeah, I killed him, so what? You should have just kept your nose where it fucking belonged.
You piece of shit. I should have fucking known.
Look, the fact is... George here misinterpreted one of my instructions.
Misinterpreted?
And I want to make things right. So, let's work something out.
What's there to work out? I'm protected, aren't I?
Your protection has limits, and I think you've far exceeded yours. That you could murder someone in cold blood like that.
You fucking asked me to do this!
And then attempt to blame me for it. You will be silent while we discuss what to do with you.
This is right bollocks, sis! You're just gonna let him do this?
So what do you say, Sheriff? Can we discuss terms? You can have Georgie. Consider it a gift. Ensuring our continued cooperation.
What the hell?
Take this fucker. Take all of them. I didn't fucking
Don't
start
make
this.
Any trouble, Georgie.
Are you seriously throwing me under the fucking carriage?
I think I'll be taking both of you.
You're not taking me, you fucking ponce. What the fuck is this shit?
You said you'd cover for us.
For minor infractions, not murder.
Just go with him, Georgie. You're gonna sink us all.
What's wrong with you people? You're really gonna sell him out just like
you
that?
You think I give a fuck if I'm the one... Who the shit do you think you fuckers
just
are?
Surrender. Get the fuck out of here.
I do apologize, Sheriff, but I think it's best if you leave now.
There's no way I'm going with him. Are you kidding me?
Things are about to get unpleasant, and I would rather you weren't here to watch.
You can go join that whore at the bottom of the lake for all I give a shit, but he's not taking me anywhere. I'll roll over on the lot of you before I let that shit happen.
What are you saying?
Yeah, what the fuck? You're gonna make sure we all go down this shitter with you?
I already told you. I'm taking both of you in, so let's go.
This could have gone so well. To speak the truth, I've never been a very good mediator. Why negotiate when you can just decide?
Did I miss anything good? Well, look at you all fixed up.
To say it was nice knowing you, but I'll be glad to see your insides turned out. gun it.
Are you sure?
Do it!
He's not moving.
Keep going!
Come on.
Right. Fuck it.
Come on! We can't stay here.
Hang on. I need a minute.
Okay. How did this...
Oh, fuck. Well, it won't be your fault.
Can you stand up? It's okay. Take your time. Slowly.
Oh, it's no fucking use. No way I'm walking out of here.
Here. It's gonna...
Shit. Hello, Bigby. I hope you'd come to your senses. Crooked Man's the one you want. But of course, you're too much of an idiot to see that. Or maybe you just like me too much to let me go.
I'm taking you in, Georgie. Let's go.
You gonna carry me?
Please, Sheriff. Haven't you done enough? Look at him. He's dying.
Vivian!
You can't seriously want to protect this guy. You know what he did.
I'm not going anywhere. It isn't his fault.
He's a murderer. Faith and Lily, he's the reason they're dead.
Look, I know he made a few mistakes. We all have.
What?
He made sure they couldn't talk with those damn ribbons, and then he killed them. You're wearing one yourself. Doesn't that bother you even a little, knowing that man murdered...
Of course it does. Those girls...
So it's all my fucking fault, then. You're gonna throw me to the fucking wolf, too? You know I didn't have a goddamn choice. What the fuck? I did what I had to! You can't fucking blame me for that!
Look, I'm
Sometimes you just have to do what you're told. Then it comes back to bite you in the ass because some good-for-nothing crooked bastard decides you're not worth shit anymore.
Why'd you do it then, huh? If it's not your fault, then what the fuck happened?
Look, Faith and the others tried to pull a run on us. And as you can imagine, the crooked man wasn't too thrilled. But of course, the big boss didn't want to get his fucking hands dirty. So he told me to take care of it. You think I don't know what that means? Either I do what he says or I'm the one getting dealt with. So I fucking killed him. And I'd do it again. Cause it's not my fault. The crooked man gave the order. He told me to kill them. And then he fucking sold me out.
You're still the one who pulled the trigger. Nobody held your hand and made you go through with it.
Ryan, believe what you want. I can tell you've made up your mind. Doesn't matter if it's fucking true or not. Go ahead and arrest me then. But it won't bring back Lily or Faith. It won't free your friend Narissa. And I'm just the sap taking the fall for the whole thing. It must be so easy being you. Just come in here and blame me for all this shit. Job's done, right? George is the bad guy. It's all his fucking fault. But what was I supposed to do? You don't know what it's like, Bigby. How could you know? At the end of the day, you're just like him.
You could have done anything else. You could have let them go. You could have freed Faith and Lily from those fucking ribbons instead of murdering them.
You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. If I freed them, what would you have me do? Kill her?
Geordie, don't.
It was them or Vivian. So you tell me, if freeing Lily meant she had to die, do you still think I had a fucking choice?
What are you doing?
I told you!
What are you talking about?
This is the original. The girl with the ribbon. I'm sure you've heard the stories. Couldn't take it off, couldn't talk about it. She used her little purple ribbon to make more of them. To keep our girls quiet. To ensure absolute discretion.
You promised you wouldn't.
All that magic is connected to this little thing. You remove hers, and the spell's broken. They're all free. But you know what happens to her? The same thing that happened to Faith. So don't you come in here and tell me I fucked up.
What the hell, Georgie? We were supposed to look out for each other. I trusted you.
You can't fucking blame me. You're not innocent here either.
Wait, those were your ribbons? You're in on this? I thought you cared about them.
I do. Of course I do. You have to understand, nobody was supposed to die. When we built this place, it was just a stupid idea. A gimmick. Discretion is our guarantee. That's how it started anyway. This was supposed to be our place. We were gonna be in charge for once, and nobody would try to control us or use us. That was the point. Then the Crooked Man showed up and everything just turned to shit.
So, do you get it now? Why I couldn't just... If you still think it's so fucking simple, then you do it. Go right ahead. Kill her then.
What are you doing?
Break the spell. Save the fucking day.
Stop it.
I told you, sometimes all your options are shit.
Why should you get to decide? Either of you. You think this is hard for you? My life is such a fucking burden on your conscience. Don't I get a say? It's my life. Like it was either of yours to give up in the first place.
Vivian, this is the way it has to be.
I know that.
Wait.
But you're not going to be the one to do it.
I'm sick of everyone thinking that they can just do what they want with my life. I thought it would be different here. But it's all the fucking same.
Vivian, I didn't mean...
Do you think I wanted to be this person? What I did to Faith and Lily... all of them.
Vivian, wait.
Every day I have to look Gwen and Hans in the eye and pretend I don't care. I have to forget what I've done to them, what I took away from them. I look at Nerissa and I hate myself.
Vivian.
I can't pretend anymore.
What are you doing?
Vivian, don't.
Goodbye,
Vivian.
Georgie.
No! Fuck! No, 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 no! Why'd you have to do that, Vivian? Vivian! Shit!
Just... Jesus.
Vivian, I didn't fucking mean it. I was just...
Get up. Get up!
Don't think so, Bigby. I'm gonna die here. I think we both know that. Just make sure you give the Crooked Man the same treatment when you find him. Really fuck him up for me, all right? For both of us.
Why do you care? Shouldn't you be more worried about yourself here?
Just wanted a nice image to part on. Old foundry by the river, all right? Shepherd Metalworks. He'll be there. Fucking asshole. You wanna finish me off now? Or do you plan to kick me around a little first? rip my limbs off one by one. That's what you want to do, right? Well, whatever it is, just get it over with.
That's not who I am.
Prove it, then. No more games, all right? We both know how this ends. Just make it quick. I know what I did.
All right, Georgie. So this is where they've been sending these.
Bigby Wolf. The Big Bad Wolf. You used to be something. They used to fear you. They'd hide anywhere their small, shivering bodies would fit.
Some things first.
Little errand boy. That's nice.
Ah, Bigby. I see you've made it here in one piece. I do apologize, but I have some business to attend to. I leave you in the capable hands of my associate. Come find me when you've finished, dear.
Don't worry. This won't take long.
Get out of my way now. Don't make this worse.
Aw, he doesn't want to play.
I'm sure you'll persuade him.
Cut this shit out!
Didn't your mother ever teach you manners? Or was she too busy fucking whatever breeze drifted through town? Oh, come on! Is that the best you can do?
Me.
Hello, Bigby. You look tired.
Give me one good reason not to rip you apart right now.
This gun holds six... I won't miss next time. Before you do anything with me, I thought I should point out a few things. Snow White wants you to bring me back to the woodlands, doesn't she? And that's what I want. You plan to do what she says, don't you?
That's right. But what happens to you once you get there is a different story.
I'm not quite finished. You will bring me back alive. Look, all I ask for is the chance to speak for myself in front of the community. And I'm sure Miss White would agree that I should be given a fair trial. Can we at least agree on that? I will have a trial. Are we clear?
You need to tell me right now. We're not going anywhere until I get some answers from you.
If you want answers, you're going to have to cooperate with me. Look, there's no reason for us to be at each other's throats here.
That's funny, coming from a guy pointing a gun at my head.
This is just a precaution. I'm sure you understand. I'm no murderer, Mr. Wolf. I didn't kill those women. And I think you know that. All I'm asking for is a chance to explain my side of the story.
If you're not a killer, then what are you?
I'm a businessman, not a killer.
There's still a lot you have to answer for.
And I will, as long as you agree to my terms. Because I'm not saying another word until I'm brought before the community. I don't mean to belabor the point, but just so we're clear, if you change your mind and decide to do something stupid, you won't get your answers. But you will have a difficult time explaining yourself to Miss White and the rest of this miserable town. You're often reckless, and I worry you're not thinking of the... Let me ask you an honest question. What do you really care about here? Where this case is concerned, I mean. Do you really want the truth? Or do you just want to look like the hero?
This is about protecting Fable Town. When some asshole murders two of our people, it's my job to bring them down.
Then why are you here? You know who murdered them. Georgie. He's dead, isn't he? My point being, the killer has been dealt with. You've won.
You really think I'm that stupid?
I understand you have an obligation to bring me in, but you can brighten up a little. It's over. So, shall we get going? I'd rather not dawdle. You know, I'm actually looking forward to seeing Miss White again. My previous interactions with her have gone rather well.
All right, let's go. Hand over the gun.
I think I'd rather hold on to it, if you don't mind. What do you say? Hey! I'm sure Miss White will be pleased. Such a reliable pup. I understand why she'd want to keep you around.
You're under arrest. You'll be given a trial in front of your peers. And your punishment will follow.
I know, but we have to do something.
Are you fucking kidding me?
When is this thing happening?
Are we sure he's coming?
Yes, you'll have an opportunity to... He's back.
The crooked man.
Thank God.
Motherfucker.
Are you okay? It's been hours. We were worried you'd run into some trouble. At the Crooked Man's place.
What? Don't I look okay?
I guess you've been worse. You did well, Sheriff. I'm surprised. Not that you did well, but that, you know... I'm just glad you made it back in one piece.
It's about time you showed up. Now throw this asshole down the fucking well.
Yes, what are you waiting for?
You killed Lily!
She was my sister!
How could you?
What do you have to say
for
yourself?
Where the fuck do you get off?
Poor girls.
You think you have the right to just do this to people? You're a fucking crook!
This? You should be ashamed.
Shithole.
Everyone, can I have your attention? Thank you all for coming here on such short notice. I know normally we'd schedule a formal hearing, but considering the circumstances, I thought it best if we do this as soon as possible. The Crooked Man is charged with the murder of Faith and...
As I already informed your sheriff, it was Mr. Georgie Pordew who killed those women, not me.
What? It was Georgie?
Georgie?
I don't mean to interrupt you, Miss White.
Georgie may have killed them, but you made the call.
Do I have to explain the situation to you again?
Wait a minute. So you're saying Georgie's the motherfucker who killed my sister? Well, where is he?
Yeah, you're gonna bring that shithead in too, aren't you?
Yes, yeah, Sheriff. Where is that rotten scoundrel now?
Is he still out there?
I sincerely hope not. Well, where is he?
Sheriff?
Don't worry about it. It's done.
Justice has already been dispatched. Bigby executed him.
He's... what?
Dead.
So you see, the culprit has been punished. There's no
that
need
doesn't
for
change
this.
Anything. We'll deal with it later, but right now, you're the one I'm concerned with.
You called the shots. Georgie made that perfectly clear.
In which case, you still have a lot to answer for. And
I was told I would be allowed to speak.
We have to read the rest of the charges.
What other charges?
If you'd wait a moment.
I'm well aware of my rights, Miss White. Unless you plan to abandon the charter entirely.
Let her finish. Then you can have your say.
Got it?
If you insist.
You are charged with the murder of Faith and Lily, which Georgie carried out on your order, inciting violence against various members of the Fabletown community, including the attempted murder of Sheriff Bigby Wolfe.
Twice.
A misunderstanding.
Aiding and providing monetary support for the forced prostitution at the Pudding and Pie. Additionally, you are charged with multiple counts of fraud, extortion, racketeering, and the illegal possession and sale of magical artifacts. Now, is there anything you would like to say?
First of all, I had nothing to do with Faith and Lily, so you can strike that one from your little record book.
Bullshit! Like hell you
didn't. Stop the charade. We know you're involved.
Come on, it's obvious.
And there's all the other crap he's done.
I know you're responsible. You've been behind all of this from the beginning, so cut the shit.
We all know who you are. We know what you've
done. Just give it up already.
The Crooked Man has committed crimes against this government and, most importantly, its citizens. These charges, if proven, are enough to justify death, upon which your body will be committed to
where
the witching
well. Where it fucking belongs.
That's
so
right.
Let's get on
but
with
we
it
we promised
then.
You a chance to defend yourself. And I won't rob you of that right.
What the
You're
fuck?
Really going
this
to let
is
him
about
talk?
Justice. If we're ever going to pull ourselves together and make something of this town, we have to start doing things correctly. No more snap judgments, no more secrets. We are going to treat everyone fairly, even when they don't deserve it.
This is ridiculous.
You have the floor.
Thank you, Miss White. You've all met Georgie. I don't have to tell you what kind of person he was. He was a total scoundrel, lacking in any sort of moral fiber. I hired him as a favor to his family, you see. A promise kept to a dying mother.
Oh, jeez.
Are you gonna get to your point or what?
Georgie was working for me, yes. But he was not acting on my behalf when he killed those women. It was his business. And for whatever reason, I'm sure only he could understand, he murdered two of his most faithful employees. I had nothing to do with it.
Tell
this is such bullshit!
You've always been a bit of a powder keg.
Give me a break. You're so full of shit.
Well, I thought we could discuss this like civilized people, but apparently
for
that isn't going
sake.
To happen.
Any of you actually believe this bullshit?
Holly, please.
Tell them, Bigby. When you finally showed up at my door last night, wasn't I more than helpful? I answered your questions. I was willing to cooperate.
What's he talking about?
Helpful isn't the word I would use.
My comrades are another matter. And I'm sorry for the predicament they put you in. They get a bit carried away sometimes, it's true. Loyal to the end. They do it because they want to protect me, as I've protected them. You understand wanting to protect what you care about, don't you? You'd do anything. You might even give up an innocent man, just to save someone.
I really hope you're going somewhere with this.
I see, you want to cut right to the point. I can appreciate that. Let me explain this to you. My employees are just that, hired help. I see some of them are here among you. They are not my slaves. They are all free to make their own decisions, as Georgie was.
What about Lily? She wasn't free. She wasn't given a choice. Do you really think she wanted that any of those girls wanted their lives like that?
I'm sorry, Holly. I'm sorry that your sister asked me for help, and I'm sorry that I decided against my better judgment to give her a distasteful job.
Right, and you kept them in debt so they couldn't leave.
Yeah, that's what you did to us. How you kept us all in line.
You forget it was not me who put you in that position. You all act like I'm some kind of tyrant. When your government abandoned you, left you poor and helpless, sniveling on street corners, I was there to look out for you.
Yes, but...
Wasn't I?
You're the fucking problem here, not us.
Really? What about Archie Greenleaf? Her story is not uncommon. She left everything she had back in the homelands. Everything that matters, anyway. With nowhere else to turn, she came to me for help. And what did I do for you?
You got my tree back.
I got her tree back. And in turn, we used her magic to help poor Fables get glamours. Because I helped her, she was able to make a living, provide for herself. And what did they do?
She wanted my tree destroyed, but Bigby refused.
What?
You were gonna burn her tree? Snow, why would you want that?
Is that true? I know what you're doing, and it's not gonna work. You can't manipulate us or these people. We're not here to talk about this.
Oh, we're not?
Bigby just
this
means...
This is important, and I'm glad it's being talked about.
You know why I asked him to destroy your tree. You were working with Crane and the Crooked Man.
It wasn't her fault.
You can lie to yourself, but you can't lie to me. You hated Crane, and you hated him for wanting to fuck you, and you being too soft to notice what he'd do to get it. It had nothing to do with the Crooked Man.
We've made some mistakes. I've made some mistakes. But believe me, I truly want what's best for this town. And that may not always be clear right away, but I want you all to know that I care deeply about all of you. And so does the sheriff.
Yeah, right.
I can't promise you perfection. No one can. But I can promise to always have your best interests at heart.
Like you did with her?
Maybe you haven't noticed, but we've been doing all this to protect you. We're trying to stop people like him.
The Crooked Man's been exploiting you. Exploiting your hope for a better life. You would go to him for help, and he would take that weakness and add it to his strength. And if things didn't fall exactly his way, someone would die.
Do you really think the Crooked Man cared about you? He just cared about your money. He cares about your obedience.
They're right.
You're all still afraid of him, even now. But you needn't be. His contamination of this town is over, and those girls will have their justice.
Very good, very good. The sentiment is surely appreciated, Miss White. But it doesn't disguise the fact that these accusations are completely unfounded. The sheriff simply doesn't have a particle of evidence linking me to the...
Georgie was working for you! Bigby got a confession that...
A confession that nobody heard. Now, I'm no barrister, but I think such a statement would carry more weight if Bigby weren't the only one to whom Georgie spoke. Especially given Bigby's... history.
What are you talking about?
Snow?
So, are we done?
And what about your history? All you've done to this fucking town?
What do you mean there's no evidence?
Maybe he's... I mean, this doesn't feel right, how we're doing this. I just need...
Of course it's right! This man tormented all of you, for profit! Georgie
Let
killed him.
Let me just make sure I understand you. You're trying to say that I'm responsible for what Georgie did, because he was working for me at the time, yes?
Yes.
Of course! Where are you going with this?
If I'm to blame for Georgie's mistakes, shouldn't Miss White be held accountable for Bigby's actions as well?
Like what?
How about the way he treated poor Tweedledee when he was in your custody? He was beaten to mashed apples while under your watch.
Under my watch?
Maybe he's right.
Did you think we'd all just let that go?
You can't be serious.
That was different.
That was Bluebeard, not me.
He was a murder suspect.
Besides, Crane was still deputy mayor when that happened. Right before you decided to kidnap him.
It was for his own protection. Oh, you're right, dear. Crane was in charge. Sometimes it's hard to tell the difference.
That's enough.
So, you won't answer for your employees' behavior, but I must perish for
this
mine.
This is completely different.
I did not order those two girls dead. It simply never happened. Georgie killed Faith and Lily. End of story. They want to scapegoat me for their own tangled ends, but they refuse to answer for their own crimes.
This isn't right.
Oh, please.
This isn't the point.
We'll deal with them after we deal with you.
Listen, I know...
The laws apply when we need them to.
Bluebeard, please.
What's that supposed to mean?
Everyone, just shut the fuck up.
I mean, a certain level of privilege should be afforded to...
To who? This is how it's always
yes.
been.
See, this is exactly to what I'm speaking. We lashed our ropes to this diseased world, and ever since, which one of us has been there for you? Who filled your lives with the promise of more? Who was there while they idly played in their towers, judging you, treating you as mindless children, too stupid to command your own destiny? Without me, who will pay your rent when you're on the verge of eviction? Who will dare challenge their brutality when it leaks to our dear citizens? Who will protect you from the big bad wolf? Who will be the-
Bigby! Miss White!
Excuse me, dear.
I wanted to make sure I had the chance to say something.
Why don't you take a moment to catch your breath, little
What's she doing here?
I'd like to... I need to say something.
We're kind of in the middle of something.
Bluebeard.
What?
She has something to say, and we're gonna listen. Go right ahead.
You probably don't remember me. I don't know why I was afraid to come
My
here.
My dear, I don't
Just
know
shut
you...
up! You enslaved us for years. Let us hear stories about what you do. Told us we would lose everything if we stepped just one toe out of line. And we couldn't say a word about it because of these damn ribbons. But you know what? Now it's my turn to talk.
How are you?
I found Vivian's body. Did you kill her? Did he?
Sheriff, this is highly irregular.
Be quiet.
We need to establish some order here.
Vivian wanted you freed from the ribbons. She took her own life.
I'm sorry, I don't think I
Nerissa!
Know
my name is Nerissa.
It's okay, my dear. It's going to be just...
He ordered them dead. This fucker. Faith and Lily...
That's a lie.
I was in the goddamn room when he did it. Faith and Lily are dead because of you. The only two people who ever gave a damn about me. And now I can finally say, you're an asshole.
And this just confirms it.
He made Georgie do it. It was always him. Georgie would have never done anything without his say-so. Ever.
You're going to take the word of a stupid...
At least five other girls will back me up on this. We all heard you say it.
Did you now?
Looks like we found our evidence.
She saw it firsthand.
He's guilty!
Good enough for me?
Me too.
So that's it, right?
Calm down the witching well.
Nah, that's too fucking easy for a crook like that.
What do you mean?
He's gotta pay for what he did.
Listen to yourselves!
You're all rats, fleeing from one sinking ship to the next. So quick to latch onto whatever will keep your miserable lives afloat. This is how you want to repay all I've done for you.
What, you take two people's lives away and now you want mercy?
You know we can't let you go free after this.
You're done talking, Crooked Man. You had your chance.
Well done, then.
Now, for your sentence.
We don't have to become murderers.
What are you talking about?
He's guilty. I know that, but we don't have to kill anybody. We can imprison him. Lock him up forever. Somewhere he can never hurt anyone again.
How can we be sure he won't escape?
I can help. We'll use magic.
That's not good enough.
There will be more if he isn't stopped.
Hasn't there been enough bloodshed?
So we get rid of him.
Too dangerous.
We can send him
away. Everyone, listen up! Clearly, we're having trouble agreeing on a suitable punishment. So I think
this is going nowhere.
Someone needs to make a decision.
Who?
I hope you aren't suggesting yourself.
Why not?
What about a vote?
What do you think this is?
Everyone, calm down.
We should have a vote. Make it democratic.
Do you really think that's going to work?
He's right. Nobody can agree on anything.
What about Bigby?
What about him?
He was appointed. He's the only official representative, really. He should be the judge.
That makes sense to me.
I guess it does.
Okay.
Fine.
Are you sure? This isn't how
it's what the people want, Miss White.
Okay. Mr. Wolf, it's your call.
Snow.
Just do what you think is right.
Yes, Sheriff. Do what you think is right.
Teach him a fucking lesson!
No.
He has to die!
We can lock him
just
away!
Just fucking get rid of him.
Not this way!
There you are. I hope you all remember this moment. Think of me when you try to sleep.
Finish it, Sheriff.
Please, we can still...
End it already.
You said you had a way to keep him from hurting people.
Wait, you can't be
what
serious.
What he's done? You're just gonna put him in prison?
This isn't the way, Sheriff.
You're doing the right thing.
Yes, there's a way.
All right, do it. Not what I was expecting. Morning, Crooked Man.
He's got a sharp tongue. I thought it would be better for everyone if he parted with it.
Thanks, Greenleaf.
Let's just call it even.
Hey, Sheriff. Are you gonna come see the truck off? We're leaving for the farm in a few. Thought you might want to. I don't know.
I'll be down in a minute.
Okay, great.
This fucking line.
Oh, Mr. Wolf, Flycatcher left his keys.
Is everything okay? You look...
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I have to take care of this. We'll talk later, okay?
Good morning, Miss White.
You're late.
Someone's gonna see you, Colin. Colin! Jesus!
We only have like 5 minutes.
And carry me for fuck's sake! I don't give a shit! You forgot these.
Oh, thank you. It's been pretty busy around here.
Morning, Sheriff. Nice fucking day. Shit! Just go grab that, would you? Sorry about all this. I know this isn't your ideal situation here.
Wait! Sheriff Bigby! I have something.
You know, he was up crying all night, poor kid.
Can you give this to Miss White, please? Dad says there's no time to say goodbye, so... if you could bring it to her... she was nice, so...
Yeah, sure.
I couldn't take them all with me, and she said she liked that one the best. It's a willow beetle. That's a big one. They're cool, because when they're little, they have these pouches that squirt juice at you if you touch them.
I'm sure she'll love it.
She said it was pretty.
We're about ready to head out.
What's it like at the farm? I've heard ogres live there, and they eat people in their sleep sometimes.
God, I hope not.
Do we have to go? I want to stay here.
Well, we don't have a choice anymore.
Don't worry. You'll be a lot safer there. There's plenty of space to run around, and a nice river nearby so you can swim all you want.
Even in daytime?
Yeah. You don't have to worry about the Mundy seeing you. It'll be nice. Come on, it won't be so bad.
Have you been there before?
No. Some of the animals aren't comfortable around wolves.
So you wouldn't know, would you?
We're all set.
Bye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, TJ.
Hey, Bigby! Where's your friend, Colin? Where's the fucking pig?
How should I know?
Saying goodbye?
Hi.
Hi.
You're still wearing that thing.
Oh, yeah, I guess I am. It's not easy to forget. I know it seems like I should be able to. It's just...
you need to let that go. How are you gonna move on if you...
Bigby, I know you're trying to help, but this is just something I need to do on my own. Listen, I came here because... I have to tell you something.
What is it?
It's about what happened to Faith and Lily. I'm not sure where to start. Faith, Lily, and I, we had this plan. We were gonna find a way out. Leave the pudding and pie for good. But then Faith decided to get some leverage. She stole a picture of Crane and Lily together.
The minute Faith stole that photo, we had dirt on one of the Crooked Man's allies. If he found out, I had no choice. You have to understand. You've seen how they kept us quiet in that place. Can you imagine the lengths they'd go just to silence someone who had physical evidence?
Narissa, what did you do?
I freaked out, okay? I thought if I came clean to Georgie, he'd get the Crooked Man to leave us alone. We could just forget the whole thing. Maybe try again in a few years.
What?
So I told him everything. And I begged for mercy for all of us. I didn't want anyone to die over a picture.
So you sold them out?
No. Yes. Georgie promised he'd smooth things over with the Crooked Man. But then... Oh, God. I don't know what happened, but that night at the club, Georgie came back and told me things had changed. He had to make an example of us. We had committed treason. And while the two of us were sitting there, as he was telling me this, Faith walked in, and I had to watch while Georgie...
Wait, so Georgie told you all this? Not the Crooked Man? Back at the well, you said...
I know what I said.
But it wasn't the truth, was it?
What does it matter? I know the Crooked Man did it. So what if it wasn't the whole truth? It was true enough.
So you think that makes it okay to lie?
I know he ordered their deaths. I wasn't gonna let him get away with it because of a stupid technicality. Especially after... That night, after Faith, I tried to warn Lily, but she wasn't with her scheduled appointment. So I did the only thing I could do. I left Faith's head at your doorstep.
You?
I walked her over here, and I left her. Just hoping that maybe if I couldn't save them...
Why would you do that?
I couldn't think of any other way to get your attention.
So you started all this?
I just... pointed you in the right direction. People like us get forgotten all the time. The Crooked Man was counting on that. When we suffer, we do it in silence. And the world likes it that way. We just fade, like we never existed. I couldn't watch that happen to Faith or Lily. Nobody cares about us. Not really.
I'm sorry, Narissa. I'm sorry that's what it took to get me to pay attention.
It'll be different now. You'll make things right. You and Snow.
I don't know. Seems like no matter what I do, it's just not enough for her, or anyone. I just can't win with these people.
I know it might feel that way, but they need you, Bigby. Both of you. You two make a good team. The way you look out for each other, and look out for us. You don't see that a lot these days.
I go out there and I do my job. I put my life on the line. I get shot at. I do what has to be done for them. But at the end of the day, I'm still the bad guy.
I know. But they'll come around. You'll see. After everything you've done for us, maybe they don't want to admit it, but without you, none of this would have happened. You listened when no one else would. You knew when to show mercy, and you brought justice to this town, finally. Because you brought the Crooked Man in, everyone saw who he really was. So from where I'm standing, you did the right thing. You've been given this job for a reason. And I left Faith at your doorstep because I knew if anyone stood a chance against the Crooked Man, it was you.
I hope I've at least done some good here.
You've changed this place. For better or worse, Fabletown wouldn't be the same without you. You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
I need to tell you something.
I have to tell you something.
I feel like we've met before.
You're trying to place me. You like my ribbon? Do you like it?
Faith wore one too. Would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom.
They used to call me the Little
Did
Mermaid.
Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
He said he wanted to run more tests.
I hope you find what you're looking for. I'll see you around.